either, either, or, or. Neither, neither, nor, nor. Either, or, neither, nor, nor, nor either.
Hi, hello students. Ever heard of this song? Either, or, neither, nor? No? No need to. It's a horrible song. Believe me. Just kidding. There's no such song as either or, neither nor. These are just conjunctions which help join sentences. In this session of subject verb agreement, we'll discuss how the verb agrees with the subject when either or, neither nor constructions are used. All right, we know that either or, neither nor are conjunctions. But when are they used? Yes, they are used when there's a choice or a condition, when you need to take sides or need to pick something over another. As Harvey Dent said in The Dark Knight,
you can either die a hero or live long enough to see yourself become the villain.
Too heavy? Okay, let's take a simple sentence. So you can either have a dog or a cat. You can't have both, so if you were to choose between a dog and a cat, which one would you prefer?
A dinosaur!
What? That was a close one. No more sentences like these. Okay, suppose I give you a sentence like, either the lizard or the cockroach has been here. Here, in this sentence, the verb is has been. Now, has is singular in nature, but there are two subjects, lizard and cockroach. Then why did we use has? It should have been have. Here lies the crux of the problem. Let's apply logic to understand the statement properly. Either the lizard or the cockroach has been here. So, there's a condition that either the lizard or the cockroach. That means both of them weren't here, any one of them was. That is why we treat each of them as an individual singular subject. And that is why we have used has and not have. Now suppose I give you a sentence. Neither the chairman nor the directors are present. Here, why did we use are and not is?
You explain.
Okay. All right, I'll explain. Don't scare me. Just remember, when one of the subjects joined by or nor is plural, the verb must be plural. And the plural subject should be placed just beside the verb. Here, out of the two subjects, chairman and directors, the plural subject directors sits beside the verb. And that is why we have used are. If the sentence had been the other way around, like, neither the directors nor the chairman, then we would have put is, because the singular subject chairman would have sat beside the verb. Sorted? One final rule to rattle your gray cells. Remember that when the subjects joined by or nor are of different persons, the verb agrees with the nearer. As in, either she or I am wrong. Here, you can see that there are two subjects. Third person she, first person I. Now notice that I is closest to the place where we put the verb. Hence we put am. If it had been either you or he dash wrong, then we would have used is. Why? Because the third person he sits closest to the place where we put the verb and the second person you does not. So in this case, it is either you or he is wrong. Too much to take in? Let's summarize fast. Either or, neither nor are just conjunctions. Two or more singular subjects connected by or nor take a singular verb. When one of the subjects connected by or nor is plural, the verb must be plural and the plural subject should be placed near the verb. If the subjects joined by or nor are of different persons, the verb agrees with the subject sitting nearer. I hope you liked this video. Bye for now. But see you soon.
Till then, keep learning.
That was my line.
Why? I should be there in this video, right?